having fun because everybody's out there doing what they gotta do, all right? So family on three. One, two, three. Family!
All right, so you can go ahead and start off with your name and how long you've been coaching.
So, Steve Henderson. This will be my 19th season at Holy Trinity. I've been coaching since I was 18, so this is my 24th year coaching high school basketball. When I first took over the program, back when I was a lot younger, Holy Trinity was not known for basketball at all. They had not won a district game. They were 4-21 the year before I got here. The year before that, they were 3-22. Our first season, we made it to the district finals. We've basically been able to build since that day. That first team that I had were extremely hardworking, and they developed a culture that I wanted here, which was blue-collar, hardworking kids, both in and out of the classroom. You know, we're the only program that has been to the Final Four three times in the last 7 years. We've won more 20-game seasons than any other school in Brevard County, so I think we're on the right path. We've put more kids playing in college than any other school in Brevard County, so that's a huge one. To me, that would be the biggest one. Wins and losses, going to state, those are all great, but giving players the opportunity not just to be successful here, but be successful after, whether playing in college or just it's exciting to see what they're doing with their lives. A lot of them now are fathers and have kids of their own. So to me, that's the special part of being here for so long and getting a coach here at Holy Trinity.
So last year you had a really good season. You went to the Final Four, correct?
Yep.
And what are you going to do this year to ensure that happens again and maybe you can go further? Like, what's your plan this year?
You know, it's every year is a different journey. And I think that's one of the exciting things about coaching. A lot of things that we're going to do are very similar. You know, we're going to instill, you know, hard work every day and showing up and being accountable. I mean, those are key components to, you know, one, being successful as a basketball team, but also being successful in life. So we're gonna keep instilling that. We push them really hard. We're gonna learn from our mistakes. Last year was an interesting year. I mean, we had a lot of ups and downs, and you know, our guys were able to stay strong together and continue to work. And you know, most people would probably not expect us to make it to the Final Four or even be regional champs last year. And the team continued to work, continued to push themselves, and that's kind of how they got there. They accomplished that. I think we're going to do a lot of the same thing. We have a young group of guys with some very good veteran guys. And, you know, I think the veteran guys know what it takes to get there, and we're going to have to teach the younger guys the importance of, you know, putting in the time and the effort and doing those type of things. Playing basketball.
Let's go. All around the world. Yeah, I know. This is so dead.
Basketball camp,
so go ahead and tell us a little bit about that and like
what
the experience was like.
So I recently got invited a few weeks ago. It was a good experience, playing against the top guys in the country. And I think I proved myself. I could be playing at the top level.
How many people got in? Like, what was the percentage?
62 athletes in the country. And like, I was 1 of 3 in Florida. One of the biggest goals is actually making it back to the Final Four. And that was a good experience. Like, I went there, got some ups and downs. But my long-term goals is to eventually play Division I basketball. And after 1 year playing there, go to the NBA.
Jay fade away, I'm throwing down passes like Jay Kidd, taking cats to the rack, and I'm dunking on them like C-Mac. When I'm in the plane, I play with that Alonzo
set. Marcel Barnes, point guard, shooting guard.
Your age?
14. My rank is number 24 in the nation.
Your first year with the HG basketball team, like, how are you feeling so far with the guys? Like, how are they, like, treating you? How are you feeling? Welcome to all that.
I feel good. The team is like, it's a big family. Like, it's all one. Like, it's nothing individual. It's just a big family. It's good. I love the coaching. Coach Henderson is my guy. Coaching is great. I love it.
What are your long-term
goals? Long-term, I want to make it to the NBA. First, I want to get it to college though. But this year, like, my high school years, I want to, like, win states. Like, most definitely get 2 states out of it. All the 4 years, 5 years.
Put it up now. Put it up, put it up, put it up now.
My name is Elijah Reynolds, and my position is point guard. My biggest impact for this team is obviously I'm an upperclassman. We have a lot of good young players, and it's just being more vocal and, you know, create for other people like Kayla, Marte, and all the other teammates. Coach Henderson, he pushes, you know, everyone, and that's good. A lot of public schools, you have like 1,000 kids probably trying out, you know, probably don't get pushed that much, but here, people come here specifically for like things that you're good at, and Coach Henderson does well for us. Short-term goal, I would say probably knowing each other better. You know, that would help on the court with us winning. And long-term, just winning a state championship, going there again. And, you know, just overcome what we did last year, just win the game.
All around the world. Put it up, put it up, put it up.
Sam Shafio, and I'm a guard, and I'm captain.
As a captain, what do you like bring to the team? Like, what are you like trying to do for the team? How do you differ from other players?
I would say I definitely bring a sense of leadership as one of the three seniors on the team and as captain. We have a lot of young guys, you know, freshmen, juniors, sophomores, so we have a lot of young talent. So I definitely just try to encourage the young guys and coach them through stuff that they haven't learned yet.
What are you trying to do while you're injured, like at practice and like also off the court when you're like just trying to do like physical therapy stuff? Like, how are you going to ensure you come back in the best shape possible?
Yeah, well, when I'm at practice, you know, I'm just trying to make sure I'm involved and, you know, watching out for any mistakes that the other guys are missing and just making sure everyone's doing the right thing. And outside of practice, I've been going to PT 2-3 times a week, rehabbing the ankle, and hope he'll be back around Christmas time playing full on again. Short-term goals are definitely just making sure everyone that's new to the system understands what we do here, like defensively and offensively, and making sure the young guys get involved. And then long term, definitely want to get back to Lakeland. You know, last year we went to the Final Four and we lost in the first round of states, but we want to get back and win championships this year.
Put up a slow hook or dish off a no look. Yeah. To draw the lane would be dumb, no, cause I send it back at you, then give you the finger like a. For the summer, you might have boosted an inch, but as long as.
My name is Coach Nino Lyons, born and raised right here in Brevard County, Rockledge, Florida. That's where I live right now. Decided to come down with Coach Henderson this year here at HT and see what we can make happen. One of the things with what he's already built down here, I feel like we can pretty much dominate in the county. And when I say dominate, I mean as far as victories on the basketball court, first of all. And then the young guys that we have down here, basically turning them into successful young men. Not just basketball players, but successful young men. I'm the assistant varsity basketball coach to him, and I'm the head JV basketball coach. My concentration, of course, will be on the JV basketball team, developing them so that they can become successful varsity players and assist the varsity into becoming the best varsity basketball team on the Space Coast, and then hopefully in our district, then our region, and then on to the state. That's where we wanna get to, the state, and then become state champions. Considering that we're young, they're very good, very talented, don't mind working. I feel very good about them. The attitudes are great. I've been around a lot of kids over the years, my 30 plus years of coaching, and I haven't seen a better group as far as attitude and willingness to work. You don't get any talk back like, I don't want to do it, or sulking. And that's one thing I like about this group. They all fall in line with Coach Hendy's, you know, his character. And that's a good thing. And I'm enjoying every day I come here.
Coach Clark, I'm an assistant coach with our boys basketball team. Have been since 2012.
What makes like HT basketball like stand out from all other like performances?
Steve Anderson really is the guy who defines HT basketball, and I think his commitment to hard work, defense, and running the floor, those three things really set us apart. But I feel like our program is different. We don't have 65, 70 guys trying out for the team. The guys who are here are guys who've come out for the summer. They've done everything that they can do to fit into our culture, to buy into academics first, making sure that we are ready to do the things that we're supposed to do, and that is rooted in being in great physical condition and really taking care of the basketball, but more than anything, playing defense and getting after it. I mean, I'm looking forward to seeing the Rockledge. I'm looking forward to seeing the First Academy. I mean, I feel like we've got a lot of good young players. Obviously, Sammy is a big part right now. He's injured, but we've got some guys who've been around and know what it's about. But yeah, we got good young players. We've got guys who are excited about being a part of it. We got some role player guys. We've got some players who are going to try to figure out where they fit. And as coaches, that's our job to help them figure those things out.
It's fabulous as playing, get used to the bench.
Antonio Johnson. I am the assistant coach. Very good player developer. Highly motivated. And I'm just here to get guys better.
So this is your first year at HT Basketball.
Yes.
What some of your prior experiences in this?
So I grew up here. Graduated from Mel, played there, and I played in college, and I continued my career. I played overseas for a little while, and I coach AAU with a few of the guys here. I'm also a trainer, so that's what kind of got me into the coaching and player development part. And I just got a call from Henderson one day, and I'm here.
What do you like about what you've seen from the guys in varsity specifically?
It's the culture. They're together. They compete. They practice hard, and they just love being in the gym. Being the assistant coach to Henderson, he's not a what I say goes type of guy. You know, we learn from each other. So if I can implement any ideas, you know, he hears me out. He puts it in practice. So it's kind of really no changes being made. We're just coming together to make, you know, what's best for the team to do what's best for the team.